Hi everyone, this is Jim Dial with Sonnax. Thanks for joining us for the second segment of our three-part introductory series on valve body vacuum testing. In the last video, I explained what vacuum testing is and why it is such an important diagnostic tool for troubleshooting transmissions. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to set up and calibrate the Sonnax vacuum test stand kit. We developed this high-quality kit as a great alternative to rebuilders going out and building their own testing rigs. This is the same equipment Sonnax technicians have used for years to troubleshoot valve bodies and qualify repairs. It's available from any authorized Sonnax parts distributor. These are the components included in the kit. The rubber mat, which is used for sealing up one side of a through passage on a valve body casting. Simply place the valve body casting on top of the rubber mat and hold pressure against it to create a seal. The test stand is comprised of the gauge, which will show measurements in inches of vacuum, the bleed and the pump knobs, the calibration port, and the test port. There are two types of tubing. One tube is more rigid than the other and features a flared end. The kit also includes a test plate you may recognize as the wet air test plate, a rubber pad, and a brass fitting and selection of tips. These tips are just to get you started. Your set will grow as you build and customize your own toolkit. A 3 CFM or more cubic feet per minute electric feed pump should be used with this test stand. The higher the rating, the more accurate the vacuum source. A pump is not included in this test kit, but can be easily purchased from a variety of sources. Setting up the test stand is quick and simple. First, take the rigid tube and slide the brass fitting over the flared end. Attach the brass line fitting to the pump and snug down with a 9/16 wrench. Take the other end of this tube and connect it to the pump port on the test stand. Be sure to push the tube fully into the quick connect. Next, install the flexible tube into the test port and push the tube in fully. The other end of this tube will be connected to the test plate and push the connect fitting after the test stand is calibrated. Finally, screw the fitting into one of the tapped holes in the test plate. Once the test stand is connected to the vacuum source, it's time to calibrate the gauge. Install the flexible tube into the calibration port on the side of the test stand. Turn the vacuum pump on. Calibrate the pump knob to 5 inches of vacuum, which is the minimum reading. This 5 inches of vacuum is based on a 35,000ths orifice bleed in the side of the test stand. It's simulating the vacuum reading of an extremely worn out valve bore that's causing a lot of hydraulic pressure leakage and a lot of transmission problems. Once the 5 inches of vacuum is set, calibrate the maximum reading to simulate no airflow passing through the bore. This is done by covering the 35,000ths orifice bleed with your finger and adjusting the bleed knob until it reads 25 inches. Repeat this process of adjusting the pump and bleed knobs until the gauge consistently returns readings of 5 inches at the low end and 25 inches at the high end. Once it does, you're ready to start testing. You should recheck the gauge once a day to account for any weather-related pressure changes. As we've seen, the Sonnax vacuum test stand kit is easy to assemble and calibrate. If you have questions about vacuum testing or how to set up the test stand kit, our tech support team is happy to help. Give us a call at 800-843-2600 or email info@sonnax.com anytime. In our next video, we'll demonstrate how to test valve bodies, establish pass-fail criteria using Sonnax vacuum test guides, and show how vacuum testing works on other transmission components. Performing these tests allows you to zero in on the root cause of transmission problems, saving your shop time and money and keeping vehicles out on the road after every repair. Watch the next video in this series and find more free tech resources online at sonnax.com.